The study conducted by Makerere University School of Public Health on the extent to which HIV stigma and discrimination affects HIV prevention interventions in Uganda has established that stigmatization of people with HIV has remained high despite efforts undertaken by the government to curb the vice. The research indicates that internal stigma of the victims is way too high at 68.6% compared to the external stigma, which is estimated at 30.9%.
Internal stigma, looking at those different indicators, was generally high. You remember what you saw with the internal stigma indicators. And what we see here, there is a slight difference between the general population and the key population, and you tend to see slightly higher stigma levels in the key population and in the female population compared to the male.
Dr. John Damulida, the lead investigator in this research, noted that young people with HIV between 14 to 24 years are more affected by stigma, characterized by social exclusion and discrimination, verbal insult, harassment, among others.
That on that first set of indicators, whether there was social exclusion and also discriminatory remarks that were made. So you'll see that social exclusion was relatively lower compared to the discriminatory remarks that made. But overall of interest, what you need to is that our thinking is that stigma is not a number. You don't need to have all this happening in order to be stigmatized.
Scientists have revealed that stigma and discrimination are impeding progress in the fight against HIV and AIDS, especially the aspect of reducing viral load among the HIV positives. This has been attributed to missing clinic appointments and missing taking drugs by victims due to stigma.
And what we found that if your stigma level was above average, you are likely to miss clinical appointment. You had higher chances of not taking drugs, and you have a higher chances of starting treatment within the first 1 month, and then receiving care in facility-based model.
In this regard, health practitioners have called upon government to scale up counseling and guidance services in medical facilities to ensure that people with HIV get enough social support to overcome stigma.
Be a reflection that our support systems at the facilities are not adequately preparing these people to accept the diagnosis, because I was imagining that the improvement, as one, the longer one knows his status being lower, would have been that there are certain social support systems outside the health facilities.
About stigmatization, it is true. The youth now, they are no more, I am talking from the village, the youth now are no longer stigmatized as they used to be during those days. Because now they talk about it freely. They can go in all health units, they have these kits. They can go there, they can be tested, and after being tested, when they are positive, they are even willing to take drugs.
The Assistant Commissioner for Community Health, Dr. Andrew Mubangizi, who represented the Permanent Secretary of the Ministry of Health at the release of these research findings by Makerere University, committed to integrate the findings into plans and budgeting of the ministry.
Seeing how we can incorporate or integrate these findings into our next interventions, into our next plans, now that Parliament is here, and when Mr. Overs comes with related budget issues, in trying to fill up these gaps for better health care of Ugandans, we hope to be supported.
This study was conducted in 22 districts selected from 15 regions of the country on 4,430 respondents. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.